Hello students, welcome to the session. So today I'm going to discuss regarding the importance of tongue diagnosis with their representation in different disease conditions. What includes in tongue diagnosis? The tongue diagnosis mainly includes observation of the body of the tongue, that is the texture of the body of the tongue. And the next point to be considered is tongue coating. So here inspection of the body of the tongue includes the color, shape, texture, movement of the tongue which reflect the conditions of viscera, qi as well as the blood. The tongue coating refers to the disease internal conditions of the organs. Inspection of the color of the tongue can reveal the conditions or nature of the pathological factors as well as their interaction between healthy qi and the pathogenic factors. What is normal tongue then? The normal tongue is characterized by a middle size, soft, neither tough nor tender, free movement, light red in color, covered by a thin and even white coating with moderate moisture, which could not be scraped away, and it has its root in its tongue. Pink tongue with white and thin coating also may be considered as normal tongue. What are the connections to the tongue? So important one is heart channel. So normally the fire element is represented by the heart and small intestine meridian. So heart is mainly controlling the brain. According to TCM, the regulator of the brain is the heart channel. So all the mental faculties or mental functions will be disturbed in case of there is any disturbance in the fire element or dysregulation of the fire element. So that can be easily reflected by observing the tip of the tongue. Next is spleen meridian. Since spleen is being producing the essence to the body, it is represented just behind the second layer, stomach and spleen. Kidney channel, that is also known as food chavo yin, an internal branch of primary channel terminates at the base of the tongue. So any changes in the spleen also can be noted in the tongue at the base of the tongue. Bladder channel, which is also known as foot thiam, a branch of the muscles or tendons channel binds to the root of the tongue. Saningiovo channel, so it's otherwise known as triple worm, a branch of Saningiovo muscle channel links to the root of the tongue. So totally heart, spleen, kidney, bladder and Saningiovo channel connected to the different parts of the tongue. So in this picture we can see the representation of the different organs at the different areas of the tongue. So tip of the tongue, especially by lung and heart, and on either side medially and laterally, we can see the area which are represented by liver and gallbladder. And just behind the area of lung and heart, we can see the representation of the spleen as well as stomach. And then at the base, we can see the kidney, urinary bladder and also the intestine. So this is how the different placement gains important in diagnosis. Normal tongue color. So normally we see red color as the red or light red, or pink with slight moisture is considered as normal. Then coming to the tongue body color. So it indicates the state of blood, yin and yang qi. So if there is any excess or deficiency of yin or yang qi, it is reflected in the tongue body. So normal tongue body refers to pink or light red color. Bluish purple or reddish purple tongue body mainly indicates the hot and cold conditions. In any cold condition, it indicates there is a constriction of the blood vessel, which is represented by bluish discoloration even in the normal pathophysiology. But even in TCM, purple color indicates the disturbance in the heat as well as in the cold. A reddish purple condition indicates the heat and blood stagnation, whereas purple indicates heat and cold excess, whereas reddish purple indicates the heat and blood stagnation. A dark red purple tongue usually dry and indicates depleted, or we can otherwise say dehydration due to the excess of heat. At light purple, bluish purple or greenish purple tongue body color can indicate cold and blood stagnation. So red tongue body is darker than the normal red. So normally we say red is normal, but there is a very dark red is indicates deficient or excess of heat or deficiency of yin. This is the difference. Red tongue with yellow coat or swollen also indicates excess of heat. So here we have to indicate the color and texture and also the structure. Red tongue body with a bright shiny coat or very little coat or no coating indicates again there is a deficiency of heat. Tip, when we observe the tip of the tongue, the red tip always indicates the excess of fire element, or also there is a disturbed heart functions. It can also refer to mainly the emotional disturbances like anger, anxiety, tension. Red tip always also indicate excess of heat. A scarlet tongue that looks like peeled or shiny indicates indeficiency, usually heat or lung, depending on the area of the swelling. So we have to see the scarlet tongue whether it is on the lung area or over the heart area. Then dark red tongue body may indicate, sometimes it's more than crimson red color, it is identified as a injury or due to trauma. Pale tongue body indicates the quality of blood, reflecting blood or qi deficiency. Normally in conventional practice also, pale tongue is indicative of anemia. If the tongue body is almost moist, tender and swollen, that can indicate it is the yang cold. Even there is a yang cold or yin cold, that is a yang cold. A pale thin tongue body usually indicates qi and blood deficiency. Apart from that red, yellow, there is also a green color. A green tongue usually indicates of excess yin cold or presence of strong excess as well as with weak zheng qi. The yang is not properly moving the blood, because the property of yang is movement, or it disperses the energy. And fluids, if there is deficiency or stagnation, that also gives a green color tongue. So internal wind may also present with a green color body of the tongue. So there are certain examples where we can see the colors: pale tongue due to yang deficiency, pale tongue due to qi and blood deficiency, and also the crimson color red tongue due to excess of heat, and mirror tongue which is representing the stomach and the kidney in exhaustion, and red tongue due to excessive heat, and red tongue due to deficient heat. So we can find out either excess or deficiency depending on the moisture, depending on the color combination, depending on the coating, thick or thin coating. So the next part will be continued in the next session. Thank you.